The final matchup of Sunday, May the 2nd, in the NCAA Division I Men's Soccer Championships from the Sportplex in Matthews, North Carolina. Brendan Boylan here alongside Sam Hyman. And Sam, we have the Seton Hall Pirates and the Air Force Falcons, two teams that you could consider surprises here in this tournament. Seton Hall entered the season picked second in the Big East. And how about Air Force, who had to win their final three games of the regular season to even qualify for their conference tournament? And what do? They make the Cinderella run. They win the tournament. They're on a six-game winning streak, looking to make it seven here in the NCAA tournament round number two.
Brendan, this is going to be a fantastic matchup. You talk about Air Force first and foremost. They are one of the Cinderella stories of this tournament, and I can pinpoint one match in particular. It was the quarterfinals against San Jose State, down 2-0 in the first half, and what happens? Air Force scores two goals and then wins in penalty kicks. Remarkable run, and they're here in the NCAA tournament.
And after conceding those two goals in the tournament, guess what they go on and do? They don't concede again the rest of the way. Over their last six games, they're outscoring opponents 16-5. And they get a big piece of their defense back today.
Yeah, and that is one of the key players to watch for Air Force before we get to Seton Hall talking about them. Jared Dove is back at the center back position. Great to hear from Doug Hill, the head coach for Air Force, on Air Force's YouTube channel, saying that this starting center back missed the last two games, and he is back in a critical spot in do-or-die mode.
Well, and that really opened the door for other guys to step up, particularly in do-or-die situations in a win-or-go-home conference tournament. For Seton Hall, they had a little bit of what we're calling Jersey Gate coming into today's action. As they're here on the outside of the 18, the cross is blocked. Their leading scorer, CJ Teebling, had a little situation with his jersey. Listen, there's a lot of travel in this tournament. Unlike any year ever, all of the games taking place in one spot. Well, number 9 was nearly number 31 tonight.
Yeah, he left his jersey back at the hotel, but great that it was able to be retrieved and brought back to the park before the action started. So he's wearing his comfortable number 9, and he is legit, let me tell you what.
Well, here's number 8 in James Booten. What a season he has had from set pieces. Seton Hall deadly on set pieces, and a big reason for it is Boot, who has the ball at his boot. All 7 of his assists this season coming from set pieces, and that is one thing that Air Force said they're going to have to do a great job. It's not just defending those set pieces, but not giving up set pieces in key areas. They've now given up 2 corners here in the first few minutes.
Yeah, and Brendan, set pieces are going to be massive for both sides. You look at these teams, and when speaking to the SID for Seton Hall, he was outlining how this team builds from the back, starting with that foundation back there, and then set pieces. It's all about set pieces, and we've seen a number of goals on set pieces in this tournament already.
Have to watch the movement inside of the 18. Headed towards goal, kept in play.
A flurry of headers there.
Seton Hall remains with the ball and sent over to a goalkeeper for Air Force that should be fairly comfortable on these grounds. We're talking about Kanoa Likewise, who has a history at this stadium as he was once a member of a USL side, Charlotte Independence, who play their home games here at the Sportplex.
Yeah, and we have seen now a couple of players, Mason Marcy, who is a player for High Point, unfortunately no longer in the tournament, but he had some opportunities to train for the Charlotte Independents as well. So these two guys, very familiar with their confines here.
Good opportunity in front and unable to get a leg on it. And they're going to call a foul. No, offside. Offside's the call on Seton Hall. Sundell was the player they were looking for, the Pirates, that is, up front. Well, likewise, has had quite a season. Four clean sheets. We mentioned the two in a row in the WAC tournament. And head coach Doug Hill had great things to say about his goalkeeper. He said, in order to advance and reach the NCAA tournament, you need a championship-quality goalkeeper, and we have that, and likewise.
It goes without saying, but you have to have somebody, as we take a look at the fans over there on the far side, some Pirates. I think that it goes without saying, but you have to have a goalie that has confidence and wants the big moment. That's the key. Doesn't just let the big moment come to them, but goes out and says, I want to stop a penalty kick.
In the box, headed away, but not far enough. And we have two fantastic goalkeepers, and you just mentioned stopping a penalty kick. How about stopping a penalty kick in the 67th minute of a Big East championship? We're talking about Andres Noda, who stops that penalty just a few minutes after Seton Hall takes a 2-1 lead and upsets the defending national champions, the Georgetown Hoyas. And his head coach said, Noda is just one of those guys. He lives for those moments. He wants those moments.
Yeah, it was a great save. I watched it so many times on Seton Hall's Twitter account. They posted the video, and phenomenal to see him go to his left and punch save it. Seton Hall just riding so high after that victory. And it was C.J. Teebling's game-winning goal prior to that, which broke the 1-1 tie, and Nota with a penalty kick save. That is just phenomenal, and it brings the Seton Hall team into the tournament with a lot of juice and a lot of firepower.
Here they go, attacking down the right flank. Looking for the foul call. No. Go for a goal kick. Well, Seton Hall's been very aggressive from the jump, winning two corners early and nearly having yet another dangerous set piece. That's what this team prides themselves on. Well, let's look at the Pirates, the number six seed. They're ranked sixth at the U.S. Soccer Coaches Top 25. This is their first NCAA appearance since 2005, and it was their first Big East title since 1991. It's been a little bit for the school in Orange, New Jersey.
30 years in the making. They've waited so long. And just great to see them back in the NCAA tournament.
Edge of the area. Left-footed cross, low. Cleared away, not cleared all the way out. And a third corner of the day for Seton Hall. J.P. Moran could not get around his defender.
And as Big East correspondent John Fanta put it in his final call of the Big East Championship, the Pirates at one point for three decades lost at sea, finding shore finally. And that they did after topping Georgetown 2-1 in the Big East Championship. So excited to see what they bring to the table here. So far just getting acclimated to the opposition.
Remember, they had lost to Georgetown in overtime during the regular season. Definitely avenged that last week. And the box still bouncing around off the volley and just over the crossbar. Nice effort. That from the center back, Luca Don. Luca Don's one of those guys you're going to have to watch out for on these set pieces. He's fantastic in the air. He's an underrated passer, according to his coach, but he's the unquestioned leader of the Pirates this season. We'll say this as we were heading to the arena for this evening's match. You could certainly see plenty of Air Force fans. Man, they traveled well. They had a whole tailgate going outside in the parking lot.
As we see Nota rising there, and yeah, this is it's great to see. It really is, traveling all the way from out west. A lot of Air Force fans. We saw some flags, and we'll get into this a little bit later, but there's some alumni in attendance as well for Air Force, which is just awesome. Some former players.
Pirates have spent a lot of time in the attacking third through the first 10 minutes of action. We are in the 11th minute. Kelmendi.
And during that sequence, there was a brief moment where Michael Nexshu didn't know where the ball was after he kicked it. It was a little discombobulated there.
And a corner kick, one for the Pirates. Well, one thing we're going to have to watch out for is Dennis Kelmendi, wearing number 18 in the white, really likes to push forward up that left flank from his defender spot. When this Seton Hall team attacks, they really push into almost a 4-2-3-1, as crazy as that may sound, that according to head coach Andrus Lindberg. Fourth corner of the early goings for James Boot. Foul on the Pirates, but a lot of energy in the attacking third for Seton Hall, and they are throwing numbers at likewise and net.
Yeah, and that was Paavo Rahijärvi, who got a little bit of a head on it towards the side bar there on that most recent corner kick. Seton Hall is definitely putting their foot on the gas right now in the early going, making Air Force a little bit uncomfortable, spending a lot of time working hard defensively.
Intercepted in the midfield. Boot. Kelmendi. Left-footed cross on the ground. Not cleared all the way out. Marin. Slide tackle. And able to get it back out. Kelmendi fighting. And a throw. Very creative as well, the Seton Hall Pirates. Air Force has spent nearly 12 minutes in their own defensive third.
Yeah, it's certainly a tough sledding and a lot of work transpiring for Air Force. They've got to find a way to get the ball on the right side of the park.
First touch of the day for Teebling. We mentioned nearly wearing number 31 this evening. They were able to retrieve his forgotten jersey from the hotel prior to kickoff.
Certainly more comfortable in his regular kit as opposed to having to wear the number 31, rocking the number 9, and one of the best players in the Big East with 6 goals, 3 assists.
Team's leading goal scorer. You might call him a target man, but he's a target man that has some underrated pace. And he can definitely beat defenders one-on-one off the dribble. He's a really special player for the Pirates.
Scored the game-winning goal in the Big East Championship match and afterwards spoke on a Zoom call with the Big East Conference and said, after a goal like that, your head is just in the clouds. It's an unbelievable feeling. And for a guy like C.J. Teebling, who's such a great worker at the forward position, well deserved of that goal.
Well, Air Force, their strongest position on that back line. A few defenders this week talking about what it took to play a team like Seton Hall. They said, we don't fear them, but we certainly respect them. And they are ready to go today. The defense is confident. That confidence grew in the WAC tournaments, and they are confident that it'll show here in the NCAA.
Yeah, that's what Max Soule said. Got to be confident and in the same breath respecting the opposition. Camille Quaracci complaining here to the official, number 17 in white for Seton Hall.
Oh, he pointed the wrong way. The official said, that's on me. It's going to be a free kick.
He was right, yeah.
For Seton Hall.
I think that's why Quaracci was so irate. He could not believe that that was going to be a foul on Air Force. And now this is, boy, you flip the script here and look at a gorgeous set-piece opportunity for the Pirates.
How about James Boot? See him on your screen. 7 assists, leads the team, all from moments like this on set pieces. And remember, the game we just finished, almost the same exact spot that Washington scored the opening goal of the game.
A low boomerang that was able to slip through the cracks. We'll see if there's a decoy here for Seton Hall.
Teebling, just wide.
Almost a 360 spin cycle there from Teebling to try and direct that one on target, but no dice.
Well, COVID-19 has affected almost every school in the country at some point. For Seton Hall, the season was paused 3 separate times because of COVID. For Air Force, they've only had 1 match postponed this season, but you want to talk about adversity for the Falcons. Started the year 1-4-1, as we mentioned earlier. Man, they've been riding the hot hand, 6 victories in a row, and you get your number one defender back as he clears it out.
Just great to have Jared Dove back there at the center back position. He's such a critical player for this squad, and the fact that Air Force was able to maneuver through the last 2 matches, which were in the WAC tournament, is very, very impressive.
Teebling flicks it overhead. Another great opportunity for the Pirates inside the 18. Headed away by Jared Dove. Pirates remain possession.
That's what we talked about. There's Jared Dove making his presence felt back there and protecting inside the 18.
Oh, poor turnover. Have a strike! Just wide. Oh, that was a rocket in your boot for Rihi Jarvi. And just wide. Oh, you could hear the bench yell, have one. Andrea Borg, number 7, checks in. Borg, a forward, sophomore. Surprised to see a move this early, especially how good Seton Hall has been in the attacking third at this point.
Yeah, I am a little bit surprised. There's definitely some strategy behind it. I think one thing that I took from the first match, High Point Georgetown, was Georgetown used so many different bodies. They actually used 5 subs in the first half. So it was a very quick and rapid changes left and right. I think maybe Seton Hall just wanting to try and get some messages sent early.
No, we're going to have our first card of the day. There is. It's yellow. Air Force's Daniel, the junior midfielder from Michigan. Luka Don wearing the captain's armband. He trots away from the ball. Boot stands over it. Boot long into the 18. Likewise, calls off his defense. And now the quick counter. Here's Tager. Oh, aggressive challenge. And we've heard the official a few times so far. I think more than anything, just trying to keep control of the game, keep it orderly. Obviously, when you have a game of this magnitude, the last thing you want as an official is to let it get out of hand. He's really setting the tone early for how this game is going to be officiated.
Yeah, absolutely. We only saw one yellow card in the last match, and just making sure that these players understand what is too much of a challenge.
Poor cross. And a goal kick for Noda.
Yeah, and Brendan, that's also going to impact how these players approach slide tackles or aerial duels. Like, that's huge. How aggressive can you be? And with these early calls from the officials, they're giving these players an idea of what to digest when it comes to those moments. And they're going to be critical moments. We may see those critical moments result in a goal.
The last few matches without Jared Dove, we saw Air Force play with a sweeper in the back. It looks like they're back to their traditional look as they fight forward. And the official waves off his assistant, says, my call is going to be Air Force with the throw. For Air Force, it's been a season full of next man up mentality. And some of these injuries have really opened the door for players to get more experience than they were projected.
Jared Dove really doing a fine job back there.
Well, can you tell we're going to say that name a lot tonight?
Yeah, he. I mean, just casually but engaged in terms of his retreat back there to settle with the possession. You're going to hear the name Jared Dove so much. And rightfully so, well-deserving.
Here's Dove on the ball. Plays it back to his goalkeeper likewise.
And even though Dove was not available in those last two conference tournament matches, Coach Hill was very quick to say on Air Force's YouTube channel in the preview for the NCAA tournament, saying that this opportunity prepared, without Dove, prepared his team with other bodies to get acclimated to the system.
Cross broken up by Maurice Williams. Seeing a little bit more from Air Force after a very slow first 12 minutes of action for the Falcons.
Yeah, I agree. This is an Air Force team that knows that when they score first, they have a great chance to win. It just shows statistically. They're 6-0. When they score first this season. So when they get that first one, it mentally just charges them up. That happens for some teams.
Well, and that was a big point for Coach Doug Hill as well, talking about his keys to victory against Seton Hall. Simply, the team that scores first typically wins the game. That's just how the game works. And so he's looking for his Falcons to come out early and aggressive. They weren't so much in the first 12, certainly have been over the last bit of play. Luka Don. Oh, and that's a foul. I thought it was good aggressive play from Jared Dove, but he's the guilty party as he tricked up Borg, who was Seton Hall's first sub of the day. Borg came on for Teebling, mentioned Seton Hall's leading goal scorer. Well, Boot had an opportunity from a similar position earlier in the first half. We'll see what Seton Hall draws up. Headed back towards goal by the Air Force defenders, and likewise able to easily collect.
Well, I don't know if likewise was happy that his defenders we're heading that back towards him. Certainly potentially troublesome.
It's a few times now that we've seen the Falcons with sloppy turnovers in the midfield. Approaching 25 minutes into the first half of action of our final game at the Sportsplex in Matthews this Sunday. Elijah Bussey on the far side looks for the long throw inside the box. Lots of big targets for the Pirates. There's a foul call.
And that's Borg, the aggressive substitute coming on for Seton Hall.
Seeing a lot of aggression from both sides here early in the first half of action. Which team can seize control? Air Force's midfield passes, not so crisp thus far.
Yeah, a lot different from Grand Canyon, who slowly, methodically was passing the ball around, but keeping it in the back tent, not necessarily advancing the ball. But, yeah, towards the midfield area, I agree with you. I think Air Force can do a better job at that.
Too much sauce on the pass, looking down the right flank. And we've seen Seton Hall's attack slow up just a little bit. Air Force trying to take the air out of the ball just a bit, regain composure and shape.
Yeah, there's just been nothing for Air Force so far offensively. A team that had 8 corner kicks in the WAC championship match against Grand Canyon. And right now, finally an opportunity where they can at least discover themselves a little bit on the right side of the park here in their attacking third.
A Haydu. Look at all that green space.
Matula is very comfortable with the dribbling and trapping the ball close to his body. Number 13 in blue.
There's Daniel into the 18. Headed away by Luka Don. Sundell arguing for a foul.
And there was maybe a little bit of a push, but nothing too dramatic.
Jared Dove. Bussey. Matulis. Now Daniel.
Matulis has been great at the midfield. Over the last couple of sequences, he's really looked to shift the ball from either the near side to the far side and has made a good decision.
Oh, final pass just not there. Here comes Seton Hall on the counter. Carici. Goal kick. Looking for Borg. Starting to see a little bit of frustration from the Pirates in the attacking third, not a whole lot going their way over the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, and I think that when you have 4 corner kicks and 4 shots, you expect to have put more of them on target, especially when you've controlled the possession for a good bit of this first half. You really expect to have more than just one shot on goal, let alone a goal.
Luke Hill, number six, checks in for the Air Force Falcons. Few changes will commence at the next dead ball for Seton Hall.
And that's Max Soule trying to use Seton Hall, one of Seton Hall's players, Camille Koyechi, to try and vault him up on that potential aerial duel, and that's why there was a foul there on the near sideline.
For Seton Hall, it will be Mons Sabo along with Jack Barrett. Those two will check in at the next availability. Calmendi, the edge of the 18, creates space, looks for the left-footed cross. Opportunity shot, just wide. Carici, golden opportunity. Couldn't get his body square for this shot.
Yeah, another look at this here on the one touch from Camille that's just spinning and spinning wide left. And he had opened up his hips a little bit more and started that towards the right side of the post. That may have spun properly, but just didn't even try likewise at all.
Or sometimes, and in that instance, Carici did not know he had time to take an extra touch.
That's a good point. He definitely had a lot of space. He had a lot of space to maybe take one touch, maybe shovel it to the side a bit, and then create a try of his own, but went with the one touch. I think that is a good point. I think maybe he could have done that as well.
One touch, place the ball in front of you, create that angle. A little ultra-aggressive. Boot. Don. Luka Don. Calmindi gets by his defender. Inside the 18. Bounces around. And unable to convert. And Sundell.
And Matisse Almeida Sundell, who you just referenced, I think he just kind of flicked it. Wasn't really trying to angle it anywhere, but there was so much traffic that there really wasn't much that he could have done other than try to get his team a corner kick.
Calmindi has been fantastic for the Pirates on the left side. He's been ultra-aggressive, pushing up from his left back spot. So look how wide the Pirates get. Their left back's nearly touching the sideline. ...13 minutes remain in the first half. Daniel, the right midfielder, blocked in front and cleared away by Air Force's Jared Dove,
who has had to work a ton in this first half. I mean, he's been everywhere for the Falcons, just preserving this clean sheet for the time being.
Looking for Sabow. Unable to control cleanly. And a goal kick. What a beautiful complex this is, the Sportsplex in Matthews. Relatively new.
Yeah, and home to the USL's Charlotte Independence. Has hosted a number of conference tournaments across the state of North Carolina for conferences located across the state of North Carolina, South Carolina, and the surrounding states.
A double switch for the Falcons. Jacob Angeliti, the junior midfielder. And number 8, Thaddeus Dewing, the freshman forward from Colorado Springs. Kelmendi. Kalmindi. Shot on goal. Easily saved. Easy for likewise.
And Air Force very fortunate there. No one was right in front of the keeper for a rebound.
Oh, nice skill. Still working. Shot just over the crossbar. Oh, what individual effort by Traeger. But unable to convert.
Quality, just quality effort by Tristan Traeger. This is the first sign of life we've seen offensively from Air Force. And take a look at this as he goes to his right. Nope, I'm going to cut back left. And spinning one just above the crossbar. What a delightful opportunity for the Falcons. And this crowd, which has a good amount of Air Force fans, would have gone absolutely nuts. Could you think about it from a Seton Hall perspective, right? You're dominating this first half, and then that first shot is almost a goal.
It would have went completely against the run of play, and sometimes that is the most deflating thing a team can experience, especially when you get late into the first half.
Yeah, that would have been a backbreaker for sure for Seton Hall. They've completely controlled this first half. And if not for Traeger, it would still be pure dominance from the Pirates. But the Falcons, maybe that gets them going here, and we'll see.
Likewise. Lots of space for the Falcons. Matulis gives it away.
And that was the fresh sub.
Well, here's an opportunity for Air Force. Nice through ball. Luke Hill can't get to it. Good thought.
And one of the things Air Force did, I mentioned the fresh substitute a moment ago, Thaddeus Dewing taking the position up top for Lathan Spatafora. So that will be intriguing to watch.
Lots of space for Barry. Both teams have done a fantastic job the last 10 minutes creating pockets of space for their midfielders. Cleared away. Corner. Yeah,
great job by Max Soule there, recognizing what had to be done, right? You do give Seton Hall another corner kick, but you cannot take any chances inside the 18. Got to play smart. And now buckle down, Seton Hall with their, yep, this is Seton Hall's fifth. I had to double clutch over there and look at the stats, but yeah, it is their fifth corner kick already.
James Boot. The outswinger. Now the Falcons can break. Great effort defensively. Carici.
That was a huge play by Carici. Stopped a potential counterattack.
That was a late whistle. What a foul on the Pirates. Roz Amir. Check in for the Pirates. Momentarily. Amir, a freshman forward from Israel. So another forward swap in the works for the Pirates. Boot. Great idea. Unable to run it down was Borg. Fortieth minute of play. So far, one or two opportunities for both sides. Air Force has been much more patient. And quite honestly, had the best opportunity of the match to this point.
Yeah, even though Seton Hall has the five corner kicks and seven shots to Air Force's one. Air Force's one shot was a blistering strike that just went above the crossbar. So I think if you're the Falcons, you've got to be happy, very happy where you're at right now after being outworked and outpossessed in the first 35 minutes or so of this match.
Throw in Air Force. Air Force, despite the start to the season, they finished strong, and this is their third NCAA tournament appearance in 4 years.
...2018 was a historic one, 17-5 for the Falcons, most wins in a season, advancing to the Sweet 16. That's what's on the line tonight, a trip to the Sweet 16 for either side.
For the Pirates, we mentioned it's their first time in the tournament since 2005, and I asked head coach Andres Lindberg what makes this team so special. And he said, college is a little bit different than the pros. These players, while we pick them and we recruit them, they also have to pick us. They have to pick to want to come play with us, and this is the first year that every single player on this roster has been recruited by Lindberg and staff. Is that enough for a penalty? No. No foul, just tripping over his own feet was Borg.
Borg, very, very aggressive for Seton Hall up top after coming on for C.J. Teebling.
We haven't seen Teebling since either.
And I'm pretty surprised by that. I'm not sure if it was any sort of injury-related situation. I certainly don't think so. We didn't see him at all in any discomfort. He just came off the pitch and has not been back out there since. But maybe it's just to rest him for the second half, although I'm not sure. Borg has been aggressive, I'll say that.
Throw in Air Force. I did see Teebling head to the locker room after being subbed off. However, he is back on the sideline in the reserve shirt outside of the dugout. Barrett. Tager. And too much for Luke Hill to go chase. 44th minute of action upon us. Strike from a long way out. Able to get his body behind it was Noda. Borg, able to control.
And Amir, that was a beautiful touch a moment ago.
Borg brought down. No whistle. Kelmindy. Shot on goal. Oh, what a beautiful save! Likewise, comes across the face of goal to make a save, and if Amir had just got a little bit more on that, we're looking at 1-0 in the 45th minute of action.
Wow, that was crazy. Likewise, it wouldn't have been that tough had he not been out of position, but he had to circle back, and all it took was a mini pirouette by Razamir, the sub who came on maybe about 5 minutes or so ago. As we take another look here, little awkward pivot by Likewise and just had to burrow himself onto the grass and stop it.
Amir just did not hit it cleanly. Oh, those are ones that you look back and you wonder. Soul into the box. No one on the receiving end. 15 seconds remain. One last opportunity to get it inside. Takes a deflection on the way through. Cleared away by Maurice Williams. Kept alive. Williams clears it again, but not all the way out. Shot on goal, blocked away, and we head into halftime 0-0. Well, what an exciting 45 minutes of action between the Seton Hall Pirates and the Air Force Falcons. When we come back, we'll have the final 45 minutes of regulation for you, and as Sam mentioned earlier, a trip to the Sweet 16 on the line. It's 0-0 at halftime. You're watching the NCAA Men's Division I Soccer Championships here on YouTube Live. We are deadlocked from the Sportsplex in Matthews, North Carolina. Seton Hall Pirates and Air Force Falcons fighting for a spot in the Sweet 16 of the Division I NCAA Men's Soccer Championships. Brendan Boylan here alongside Sam Hyman. Sam, seemed like Seton Hall really had their foot on the gas to begin the match. And though the foot came off the gas just a little bit, they looked to dominate the Falcons on the stat sheet.
Yeah, I mean, the foot came off the gas for just a split second, and Air Force nearly had the lead. That's how close it was with a shot on target by Traeger. But, yeah, you look at these numbers, and Brendan, it's very one-sided. 9-3 Seton Hall leads in shots, corner kicks, 5-0 in favor of the Pirates. So nothing, barely any opportunities for Air Force, let alone just getting set piece opportunities. They haven't had anything really. And then the amount of times we've seen Seton Hall just possess the ball on the left side of the park, now they'll be switching sides, is just a drastic change with these two teams. It's got to have more flow for Air Force if they're to, you know, find a way to put together something.
Well, Air Force has a lot to be fighting for. They have plenty of loyal fans in the stands today. Great travelers, as we mentioned earlier, some of them tailgating, but a really special group of alumni to support their Falcons today.
Yeah, and I was very lucky enough to catch up with Doug Hill before this match just a little bit, and he mentioned that there are some players from the 1993 Elite Eight team from back in 1993 that are here watching the Air Force Falcons here tonight. There are three players in particular he pinpointed. Chris Cullen, who Doug Hill said is one of the best players to ever come through Air Force. Jay Clark and Gabe Macias. Three guys, Cullen, Clark, and Macias, who were instrumental in Air Force's run to the Elite Eight back in 1993. So just great to see that some alumni have decided to come back and watch their Falcons here tonight. It's just awesome.
And for Seton Hall, they have a lot to be playing for as well. This team really plays for the history of Seton Hall, and this year they decided to honor one of their former players in Peter Scavo, who was a Seton Hall guy through and through, according to Andres Lindberg. He unfortunately passed away this year, and they're honoring him by bringing his jersey, a framed jersey that was presented to his family. They're bringing it with them throughout the NCAA tournament. That jersey was in the dugout when they won the Big East for the first time in 30 years. And they're hoping that him and his legacy brings them some more luck tonight. A trip to the Sweet 16 on the line.
Yeah, just two great stories, both different in their own right, but that's awesome that they are bringing, Seton Hall is bringing that jersey just as a reminder and just a cool situation to pay tribute to somebody who is gone too soon.
Both sides honoring some alumni tonight, and the biggest way they can honor those guys is with a victory. See who can break the deadlock. Here are the Falcons. Matias. Bussey. A nice move by Bussey.
Yeah, I've been very impressed with the footwork from Air Force, not only in that situation with Bussey, but how Tristan Traeger got open for his shot that nearly went in, just went over the crossbar, and that was individual work to get the separation. We've seen some fantastic dribbling by the Falcons here this evening.
Well, and for the Seton Hall fans that were wondering, I did mention right before halftime, I noticed that C.J. Teebly headed to the locker room, but he was back out towards the dugout. He's back out and on the field wearing number 9. Looking to make a difference on the pitch today. Sundell loses out.
Teebling only played 19 minutes. A little under 19 minutes in that first half.
And the foul, the guilty party, is Pex. Right back for Seton Hall. Daniel told to back it up on the free kick. Quickly switches the field of play. Daniel.
And that's like the only mistake that Jared Dove has made for Air Force, just that pass too far.
Cook. Oh, nice turn. Angeletti. Lost it.
And Maurice Williams with a casual shove there. Surprised they kept playing.
Teebling onto his left foot. Took a deflection. Corner kick for the Pirates. They're 6th of the day.
And there's C.J. Teebling getting activated just outside the 18. That is what he is known for. The activity up top, really trying to generate something for the Pirates.
James Boot, sophomore from Southampton, England. Part of Bournemouth's academy system. Foul on Seton Hall. We've talked about how dangerous Seton Hall is from set pieces. They're certainly getting them, but not a whole lot of good looks.
Yeah, we really haven't seen too many brilliant services into the box, Brendan. I think that has not allowed any sort of delivery on cage, just to put it bluntly. And hopefully with this Seton Hall team, they get better and better at those corner kicks. Just nothing that has been of exceptional quality so far.
Teebling turns, has time, cuts inside. Teebling continues. There's Cook. Throw in Seton Hall. Teebling. Soul. Nice bit of pace. And a foul.
Yeah, brilliant stop and start there from Max Soul. Fans loving it. This Air Force team has speed. They have shown the ability to win their 1v1 matchup as we look at the Falcon faithful showing out here tonight. And they're showing out for Lathan Spatafora, with his first name on each of those fans.
I was about to say, great timing by them to get back in a position. Yeah. As soon as they got in the shot, they knew to get back in a position. Here's the service. Punched out by Noda. All the way back to Cook. Teebling. Gets by one. Leaves it for Kelmindy. Kelmindy works his way through one, through two. Cross the box. Cleared but not all the way out. Here's Pex. Great delivery. Headed on. Oh, a big save! Likewise! A huge save. Denying Sundell in front of goal. And it remains 0-0.
That was spectacular. Just quick reaction. Can't wait to get another glance at that when we have a second.
Great service into the box by Pex as well.
Yeah, I was just talking about how there have not been a lot of great services by the Pirates, specifically on corner kicks. Well, this was a live service that looked very promising and quite nearly put the Pirates up 1-0.
Pex, the aforementioned man, with the interception. Sundell. Out for Pex. Deja vu. And sent over by Sundell. Two great opportunities for 13 in front of the net. And look at this service in the box.
Wow. And the header that nearly gets by likewise. He bobbles it and is able to keep this at 0-0. Wow, what a situation here by the Pirates knocking on the door.
We've seen them attack both flanks with their fullbacks. Great first half by Kelmindy. Pex with incredible service here thus far in the second half. Cook wins the aerial duel. Ball out of play to the Pirates. Sundell. Teebling. Oh, look at the pace of Teebling and the strength. Cuts inside. Teebling. Shot on goal. Oh, just wide. On the wrong side of the net. Some of the Seton Hall faithful thought it tickled the twine.
Yeah, it was kind of a tough angle from where we are situated. And especially if you're far away, Teebling making his presence felt as the Pirates putting a lot of pressure on Air Force. Teebling has 6 goals to lead the team. And Sundell, who quite nearly had his second goal of the season.
Williams. Teebling. Marin simply slipped. Air Force looks to move quickly. Dove. Now Cook. Daniel. Well, here's a great opportunity. Unable to put it on target.
Another look here. This is CJ Teebling. Gets the step and with a left foot. Man, it really had a chance, but too much bend. It's a great job by Teebling, knowing how much separation he needs to get that shot off. A little sidestep.
Luka Don. Long service. Foul. We're going to have our second card of the day. It's yellow. Luka Don remains down. It's going to be Thaddeus Dewing who receives the yellow card. And they're going to call for the medical staff Let's take a look at Luka Doncic.
Let's see if we can see. I just
clipped him on the foot on the follow through. Yeah. Those hurt.
Yeah, that's really painful. Really painful. Stepping right on that left foot, I believe. What a game. What a game this has been. Still nil-nil between these two sides. And if you look at the stats, it certainly proves that Seton Hall has owned this match. But you could argue that the chances that Air Force has had have been of quality and very much close to putting them up 1-0 as well.
Official talking to his assistant. Leave everybody getting on the same page on who the card was on. As we mentioned, it was Thaddeus Dewing, number 8 for Air Force, the guilty party. He was shown a yellow. As we'll have the restart with 33:25 remaining in the second half. Who will break the deadlock? Headed on. Opportunity for Seton Hall. Oh, save on the goal line. It's Dove, the defender who saves the day. Seton Hall, opportunity after opportunity, and yet another one kept out of the net by the Falcons.
Twice there in that one sequence, Matisse Sundell. Oh, my goodness, take another look at this. There's one save deflected, and then that's Air Force's number 12, London Agedu. Wow, what an unbelievable reaction.
Substitution for the Falcons.
Agedu and Dove were involved in that.
Goalkeeper asked to certainly go back to them and say, hey, thank you. So without you, it'd be 1-0. Falcons bring back on Elijah Bussey. And Seton Hall. Now three opportunities on goal.
It really feels like the Pirates should be up 1-0, but you have to give a ton of credit to what Air Force has done. They've buckled down and have not absorbed a goal. There's fighting inside the 18. A lot of credit goes to not only Jared Dove and Gaydu on that particular sequence, but they've been all over the defensive third of the pitch, just getting things out of trouble when it looks like the trouble would haunt the Falcons.
Here's Pex. A couple great services from his right back spot in the second half.
Yeah, he's been outstanding.
Well, you can only imagine the longer that Seton Hall goes goalless in the second half, the more and more confidence and momentum that will swing towards Air Force.
And that's really what happened in the first half, right, when it was completely dominated by Seton Hall first 35 minutes or so, and then, boom, we nearly see Tristan Traeger pour one in top shelf. Now the question is, what is Air Force going to do? How are they going to draw something up? They do not have a corner kick in this match so far compared to Seton Hall's six, so not a lot of set pieces.
Bussey with the left foot cleared away by Williams. Cook. Williams keeps it in play.
Great pivot.
Williams clears it away. Sundell. Oh, a turnover. Back and forth possession goes. Clean challenge. Next shoe. Overlapping run by Soul. Oh, offside. The flag is up on the far side. The flag is up on the far side. No goal.
Wow.
They're not going to call it offside. They're going to say the ball came out of bounds and came back in the air. It is a goal kick, no goal, but you could certainly hear the Air Force fans on the other side.
Another look at this cross here as it is bending out and then came back in. A very weird cross that literally went over the top of the goal and then somehow, with the angle, ended up on the back post.
Chance of let's go Air Force from the crowd here in Matthews. Teebling tries to go through by himself. Substitution for Seton Hall. Borg back on the pitch. He had quite the influence on the first half. Lots of energy from the forward.
Yeah, certainly did. A lot of great runs that did not produce a goal, but his work rate really made this Air Force defense have to move and have to move very quickly in that first half.
Here's Borg. Outside. Kelmendi. Back to Borg. Borg, outside of the box, free kick one right outside of the edge of the 18. Another dangerous set-piece opportunity for one of the best in the country to do it.
And this is pivotal right here.
Handball right outside of the box on the edge of the 18. Oh, look how close that was to being a penalty. Can't get much closer than that. Discussion on how the Pirates want to go about the free kick. Boot. Scores! A goal directly from the free kick. It is Boot. It's his first of the season. He had 7 assists from free kicks this year, and it is James Boot who puts the Seton Hall Pirates up 1-0 here late in the second half.
Wow, what an absolute missile from Boot. We know he has so many assists from this set-piece situation. Well, here we go.
Oh, I think it took a deflection on the way through. It took a deflection on the way through. I don't think it's going to be awarded to Boot. We'll see it one more time.
Yeah, just barely.
It did take a deflection on the way through. Going to wait for confirmation on the goal. We thought it was Boot, but Boot's going to get his 8th assist from a set piece this season. And I believe the goal is going to go to Paavo Rihijärvi, number 20, on the headed effort towards goal.
Yeah, really hard to see, but I think you might be right there. It was just grazed, barely.
Rihi Charvi barely redirects from James Boot. Boot will get his eighth assist of the season, all coming from set pieces. And what Seton Hall's bread and butter has been throughout the year gives them a 1-0 lead late in the NCAA Division I Men's Soccer Championships. Oh, they're only 26 minutes away from an appearance in the Sweet 16.
That is unbelievable. And going back to Boot, I mean, I'm wondering if that did not touch anybody, was that still on its way to Cage? Like, was that going to be a goal even if it wasn't partially grazed? That's how wondrous of a ball it was from Boot.
Free kick won by Pex. We'll see it one more time on our screen. And a free kick won in a dangerous area for Seton Hall. It's going to be interesting how they end up scoring that one. I do think it's Rihi Charvi who got his head on it.
Yeah, that's what it's officially scored as, with the assist from James Boot. And now, here we go again. James Boot, can he dial something else up right here?
Boot into the 18. Headed out, but not cleared. Seton Hall will let it trickle across the line for a throw-in.
Air Force has been walking on a thin sheet of ice this entire match, Brendan, and it was really only a matter of time, given how many opportunities the Pirates have had here tonight. The shots are extremely one-sided. 16-4, Seton Hall leads in shots. And 6-1 shots on goal.
Boot, an effort off the post. And they'll trickle out for a goal kick. Boot, the man who just had the assist, nearly had a goal.
Tell you what, Seton Hall is playing up-tempo, using all these set pieces. That's their bread and butter. We talked about that at the top, how this is a team that builds from the back. They're back four, very strong, but they succeed on set pieces. That's their bread and butter, and they've made their mark on that today. As there's a major collision here with Reese Cook charging right over top of J.P. Marin, who falls down and is in some pain. Another look at this. That may have been unincidental.
No card has been shown. Conversation to happen.
The elbow just hit Marin, but it wasn't a, didn't look like a forceful attack there up in the air.
Another free kick for the Pirates. Boot inside the 18. Rihi Charvi. Goal kick. Twenty-3 minutes remain in the second half, 1-0, favor of the Pirates. Goal in the 64th minute, right now awarded to Paavo Rihi Charvi. However, that may change. Here's Teebing. Borg. The edge of the area, Borg inside the box. Cleared away by Air Force. Pex. Marin. And cleared away by the Pirates. Seton Hall has picked up the pace over the last 10 minutes.
and Brendan. So after further discussion, I'll mention it in just a second.
Teebling fired, but straight at the keeper.
After further discussion with Seton Hall's SID and our official scorer, the goal will actually be awarded to James Boot.
James Boot, his first goal of the season. That's how it initially looked. It did look like it took a deflection on the way through. But all in all, James Boot, goal number one on the year. Hey, it's only fitting. You have seven assists from set pieces. Yeah. You might as well get one for yourself.
Exactly. It's well-deserved. It was going in anyways, had it not been just partially just grazed. Everybody went to celebrate with Boot.
Air Force inside the 18. Oh, looked like a beauty for a moment. Headed away one time. Right at Noda.
Daniel with a nice one-timer in the air. Got to try to find a way to put some pressure here on Noda, one of the best goalies in the country who had that massive PK stop in the Big East Championship against Georgetown.
Sundell looks to fire. Blocked away. Teebling couldn't get to it. Air Force on the counter. And Boots begging, saying that he dove. But the official isn't having it.
That's exactly what Air Force needs. Just something to reassess, even though this is well outside the 18, just to get reorganized.
Oh, great 1-2. Foul on Soul. The attempt was saved anyway. But brilliance on the right flank by the defender, Max Soul. But he gets whistled for the foul.
And Air Force cannot believe it. They thought that there was a foul on Seton Hall here as we see Soul rushing in. And you can see Borg tries to get in there, but Soul with the elbow reach.
It's the extension of the arm. That's the reason Soul gets called for the foul. Williams sends it long for Teebling. Seton Hall's leading goal scorer. Drops it back for Boot. Who's today's goal scorer? Ball out of play. Minute. Just 8 minutes ago, James Boot broke the deadlock. Williams. Noda. Max Soul for the Falcons. Oh, look at all that room for Soul. Goal kick.
Well, Soul has at least provided a spark with some energy on that right flank. Pirates the Falcons got to get some set pieces here.
Soul appears to be injured. You saw on your screen Noda waving for the training staff. And another break in the action in the 73rd minute. Fell awkwardly on his shoulder. Let's have a look at the goal that broke the deadlock one more time. Direct free kick. They're going to give it to number 8, James Boot. With his first goal of the season.
What a great ball that just had a pathway towards greatness. And he is so well deserving of that after all those assists on set pieces.
While it's being awarded to Boot, Marin may have got a piece of it. Regardless, I don't think they care who scored as long as the team is up 1-0. But Air Force has been coming back. They've been coming back with some fight. Max Soule providing a bunch of energy down the right flank over the last 5 to 10 minutes of action. Luka Don sends it long. And a goal kick. Hear lots of encouragement from the Air Force side. Their dugout. Just shouting words of encouragement and wisdom to their teammates. Seton Hall side seems a little bit more on edge. Kelmindy can't get around the defender. Inside the 18. Mary. Back to Boot. Kelmindy. Strike inside. Throw in for Air Force. That was, ball had quite the amount of whip on it, for lack of a better term.
Yeah, it really did. Nobody home, but a nice service into the box.
Sundell. Effort from a long way out. Easy for the keeper. Dove. Sundell. Kelmindy. Nice challenge. Here's Air Force on the counter. Next shoe. Bussy. Takes a deflection, and it's in the back of the net! The equalizer! It comes from Tristan Tager, who had the best opportunity of the match in the first half, and just like that, 1-1!
Air Force not done yet. They were extremely energized following absorbing that one goal. Really ready to equalize, and as we take another look here, it's a beautiful touch by Bussy. And then Traeger off the deflection. And look at Noda just backing up, falling backwards, and cannot tip it forward. If his fingertips were a little bit longer there, we could be talking about an unbelievable stop. But no dice. We're tied.
Tristan Tager scores in the 75th minute to knot it up 1-1. Final 15 minutes of regulation will be vital.
Yeah, now the intensity is really climbed up with this 1-1 contest right now. Really intense.
The goals just 11 minutes apart. Directly from the free kick, it was James Boot for Seton Hall. Off a great passage of play and a deflection. It was Tristan Tager. He's on the ball now. Takes a shot. Deflected.
A lot of spacing on that buildup from Air Force.
Air Force inside the 18. They drop it back for Bussey.
Air Force moving extremely well in this sequence.
Tager can't head it home. Corner.
It has been an unbelievable stretch here from the Falcons. Over the last minute or two, they have had such phenomenal buildup, Brendan. It has resulted in a lot of pressure on the left side of the park. And finally, the Falcons get their first corner kick.
Matulis to take. Bussey short if they want to play it that way. Williams with a head to it. Stays with Air Force. Daniel. Cleared away. Here's Boot. Seton Hall looks to counter. Marin. Give and go. Boot. Kelmindy. Side the 18. Controlled by the Falcons. Williams. Marin. Sundell. Oh, couldn't turn his hips.
Yeah, that's a tough one to square up with your body moving so quickly away from cage. Very hard to cut back.
Intense pressure back and forth. That's what we'll see for the next 10 minutes.
We saw so much energy right after Air Force scored. They were moving the ball so well. Crisp, tight passes that nearly resulted in a second.
Teebling can't get there. Foul whistled on Sundell. We're in the 80th minute. Daniel. Cook. Look at the defender. Bussey. Flag is up for offside.
And that was Bussey doing a good job of cutting that down before it went out, but the flag is up. It's going to be a very intense 10 minutes of action here. In regulation.
Matulis gives it away. Tager, the goal scorer. Max Soule. Cutting inside. Give and go. Oh, what a great effort. No penalty. What an effort by Luka Don. Takes it off the feet of Tristan Tager, who was looking for the brace and the go-ahead goal with less than 10 minutes left. Luka Don, maybe the play of the match to this point.
Stunning right there. That was looking very promising for Air Force.
Teebling on the edge of the 18, inside the area. Cleared away by the Falcons.
Air Force again thinking that they were fouled inside the box on that situation a moment ago.
Tager chips it forward. Williams. No foul. Max Soule. Tager. Bussy. Cleared away by Boot.
Just outworked there a moment ago by Pex.
Now look at the time and space. Here's Daniel.
And these officials are letting these players play through a lot of contact. Wow. We still play on. Finally, the officials stop play.
I think it's going to be for an injury. Pex. Remains down on the pitch. Here's the effort from Luka Don.
Yeah, and that is a nice job of using his body to get that ball.
I'm okay with it. I'm okay with the no call, especially how physical and how they let them play over the last few minutes.
And that,
to me, that's a foul, and I believe it's what was called. I believe that's going to be a foul on Air Force. Matulis was the guilty party. No foul was called. Drop ball.
Both sides a bit confused right now.
Jake Barry on the pitch for Seton Hall. Air Force brings back on Thaddeus Dewey. Soul. Worth the effort. Yeah, bad Afora.
Definitely got to take chances with this clock winding down. Air Force has really come on strong here in the late stages. Been impressed with a lot of their players, especially on that right side. Max Soule has made some terrific runs, and then Tager, a beautiful effort in the cage. Nearly scored in the first half as well, but had the finishing touch on the equalizer here in the second half.
Soule. Pex with the interception. Cook. throw in Seton Hall. Roz Amir had a golden opportunity in the final minute of the first half. He's checking in for Sundell.
He's played very well tonight for the Pirates.
Three forwards on the pitch for Seton Hall. Borg, Teebling, and now Amir. Looks like they're going to go after it. But Air Force has had all the momentum over the last few minutes. Here's Cook.
And I like the move by Seton Hall with the three forwards, bringing a lot of pressure up top to try and get one here before regulation. But you're going up against an Air Force team that has the momentum, so they are hanging out a lot on the attacking third.
Borg sends it forward. Teebling can't get to the end of it. Air Force throw. Eighty-sixth minute. Bussey. Broken up by Boot. Air Force throw.
So much on the line right now with these two teams coming in very hot in the NCAA tournament.
The AR official listening to his AR, Seton Hall throw.
Of course, you got Seton Hall, who's coming off a Big East championship over Georgetown, the defending national champions, and then this Air Force team, third NCAA appearance over the last 4 years, and the Cinderellas of this field, at least one of them. I go back to that quarterfinal round against San Jose State. We documented it quite a bit, but they were down 2-0 in the first half, tied it up 2-2, and then won in penalty kicks. And since that moment, you could argue even a little bit before that because they've had some wins prior, but that really catapulted them into the national spotlight and went on to blank the next two opponents in the WAC tournament. It was a fabulous run.
Cook called for the foul. Oh, and he shows a card to Cook.
As we take another look here.
Oh, he got the ball.
Yeah.
I understand the frustration from the Air Force side. Because what does this do?
It puts
Seton Hall in a position where they have been masters of finding the back of the net. Seconds away from the 88th minute of action. Seton Hall looking for a little bit more magic out of the right boot of James Boot.
Too much there. Too much of a boot.
Eighty-eighth minute of action. Seen aggressive play from both sides. Emotions running high on both sides. Foul on Air Force. Barrett. Throw in Seton Hall. Teebling. Tries to turn. Teebling. To his right foot. He's got it! Seton Hall's leading goal scorer might have just punched their ticket into the Sweet 16. Great hold-up play by number 9. And Teebling finishes it with a rocket in his boot with his right foot. 2-1, Seton Hall.
Wow, Brendan. As soon as C.J. Teebling cut back with his right, we know he can finish with his left, but when he cut back with his right, I was saying, uh-oh, as far as Air Force goes, look at this right here. He traps it, shielding off the defender, cuts back with the right foot, and blasts it straight upstairs. Magnificent work. And Teebling, who scored the game winner in the Big East Championship, he may have just scored the game winner. As long as Seton Hall can hang on, but you know in this final 90 plus seconds of action, Brendan, we're going to get an all-out blitz from Air Force to try and equalize.
Against the run of play, it felt like Air Force was knocking on the door. And Seton Hall, led by their team's leading goal scorer in the 89th minute, it's C.J. Teebling that might have punched the ticket to the Sweet 16.
Unbelievable match. This has been absolutely as advertised. And whoever wins, whoever loses, we should tip our caps to both these sides. As lopsided it is on some of these statistical numbers, shots on goal, Seton Hall 9, Air Force 3, corner kick 6 for Seton Hall, 1 for Air Force. This has been extremely intense and very much back and forth. There have been spells of 5 to 10 minutes where one of these sides has controlled the pace.
90th minute. Foul. Is the clock going to stop? They haven't stopped the clock. Getting very, very emotional. There was another yellow shown to Air Force, and the official finally says stop the clock. There was a foul on Air Force. A yellow card issued. And following the scrum, it will be a free kick for Seton Hall. Air Force arguing to put more time on the clock as well.
Yeah, and there was a yellow card issued. The clock might not. Well, now it's back up to 29. Seconds left here in the 90th minute. A little bit of chaos here as we wind down this regulation period.
Well, emotions running high. Air Force trying to not see their Cinderella season end. Seton Hall trying to go to the Sweet 16 for the first time in quite some time. Their first NCAA tournament tournament appearance since 2005. They just won their first Big East title in 30 years. Nota puts it back in play, and he boots it downfield. Less than 30 seconds remain for the Falcons. Teebling trying to bring it to the corner. Won by the Falcons. Now the Pirates to play keep away. And the clock strikes midnight on Air Force's Cinderella run of six straight victories that brought them into the NCAA tournament. They fall to the Seton Hall Pirates by the final score of 2-1 behind an 89th minute winner from striker number 9, C.J. Teebling. Sam, what are your final thoughts on what was an excellent way to finish the action here at Matthews, North Carolina?
I've got so many. I've got a laundry list, actually, but I'll keep it brief. C.J. Teebling, remember, we brought this up earlier in this match where he said after the Big East Championship win over Georgetown that when you score a goal, when he scores a goal, his head is in the clouds. I'm certain that he is in the stratosphere right now thinking about this moment with the cutback. We saw him score this season with the left foot. There it is with the right as he buries it upstairs. And what a special moment as the Pirates are moving on. This is certainly a demoralizing loss for Air Force given how they really turned it up quite a bit in that second half. It looked like Air Force was down and out even though it was tied 0-0 at halftime. It looked like Air Force wasn't going to be able to compete today with the Pirates, but give a lot of credit to this Air Force team. They fought pretty hard. And how fitting. This is the second ever meeting between these two teams. They met back in 2005, the last time Seton Hall was in the NCAA tournament. So fitting that this is a matchup that brings back the Pirates to the NCAA tournament. So, yes, all I can say is C.J. Teebling after this one, but there are a lot of names to pinpoint, and I certainly want to recognize Air Force's player, Jared Dove, who was spectacular as well. But as you can see right now, all smiles for the Pirates after an unbelievable finish.
Well, I'm sure South Orange is buzzing, a Sweet 16 ticket punched because of number 9. It's C.J. Teebling who makes it 2-1 in the 89th minute. Well, that's all the time we have from the Sportsplex here in Matthews. It's been not just a fun day, but a fun week of action here in the NCAA tournament. It was all hosted by Wingate University. Well, thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to make the NCAA Division I Men's Soccer Championships a part of your week and weekend. For Sam Hyman, I'm Brendan Boylan saying so long. We'll see you next time.